What may look like a mound of soil that is loosely breaking is actually a dike that is supposed to protect villagers of Kokwaro village in Kano Plains from floods that get into their houses. But are these dikes getting destroyed because of lack of maintenance, or is it something else that is reducing their lifespan, making the residents vulnerable to flooding that destroys lives, property and their livestock?
Some people in the community remove those dikes to make sure that the waters which are in the river can overflow to the farms so that their animals can graze. This makes it difficult for the next el-nino to come to find that dike is still there.
It is for this reason that the aftermath of the April rains can still be seen in swampy areas of Kano Plains, waters they take advantage of to do rice farming. And now that the rains have been predicted to begin in about 2 weeks, what then for the residents in this area?
Sisi tunakalia tu maji inakuja tu fao na unasikia tu oh pengine kama uko usingizini na unapata nyumba yote inalewana na maji.
In Budalangi, the situation is similar. Dikes that were repaired early this year have partly been washed away by the April rains. Rains that were not as heavy as those that are expected in October.
Ile maji inakuja na nguvu kulikweli. Kama serikali inaweza kutengesea vizuri, wanaweza kuleta ile simiti wakajenga vizuri kama vile mtu anaweza kujenga nyumba.
Inabidi watafute njia yoyote ya kuziba hiyo maji isipatikane kuja huku kwa ile njia ambayo inafuata.
Serikali tunataka itimbe mabao. Ile walikuwa wanachimba hiyo. Kama wanafanya hiyo tunakuwa tu vizuri.
Every time it rains in Budalangi, River Nzoia bursts its banks and villages around the areas are flooded.
At the point where the river meanders is where the force is greatest, leading to the breaking of the dikes, and the villagers in the areas bear the brunt of the rains. The Budalangi dikes were constructed almost 40 years ago, and they usually have a lifespan of over 20 years. The government is currently giving them a facelift so that they can survive the coming rains, but are there any efforts towards a lasting solution?
We are going to have permanent dikes, and there's an engineer and a consultant from Britain who's working on a new set of dikes. So in a year, we are likely to have new sets of dikes.
The government should educate the community that once a dike has been constructed, they should not interfere with it. That is one. Because it will help in the next El Nino.
It is paramount that a lasting solution to the flooding menace in Budalangi and Kano Plains is arrived at, particularly now that the effects of climate change are taking a toll on the country. Olivia Ketch, Citizen TV.